Okay, the next part of this tutorial is I'm gonna show you how to work the dog bone, and I'm gonna show you the components here, because the dog bone consists of 5 components. It has the middle section of the bone here, and then there are 4 of these round circles that strategically just go over the edge halfway. The other one is up on the other side, and then obviously the other 2 are on this side here. And it's when you sew it onto your actual project that it gives it the bone impression. So that's not really hard, is it? Make sure you leave on extra strings so that you can, when you fasten off, so that you can sew it onto your project. So let's begin the middle section of doing the bone. So let's begin the first section here of the bone. We're gonna start off with a slip knot, and I want you to chain 15. Remember that the one on the hook right now does not count as 1. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Second chain from the hook, just come around, turn it around, get that back one, and then just single crochet yourself all the way across. This is row number 1. So this bone right in the middle only is 7 rows, and it's all it is, it's single crochet back and forth. That's how easy it is. So just continue just to single crochet across the chain. I'll meet you in just a moment. When you get all the way across to the chain, you get that last one. So this is row number 1 of 7. Turn the work, chain 1, and then just begin to single crochet. And please do this for 7 rows, then fasten off. All this is just a rectangular all done with single crochet. So that's how you do the middle section of the bone. I think it's very self-explanatory at this point. So continue to do that, and then you can finish that off, and then I'll show you how to do the ends of the bones, which are the round circles, next. Let's begin to do the round sections of the bone. You'll need to do 4 of these. So we're just gonna start off with the slip knot, and we're going to do this very much like the paw prints, but there's 3 rounds instead of 2. So this time it's chaining of 2, 1 and 2, and then 6 single crochets into the beginning chain. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We don't want to do anything with this slip stitch or anything. We just want to continue to the next one and the next round. So round number 2, every one of them is going to get 2 single crochets. So this is how I do it. It's just like the paw print, is that here's the first one. So I go 1 and 1. There's 2 in that first one. And then I go 2 and 2. So there's 2 in that one. And 3 and 3. And we have 4 and 4, 5. Whoops, not doing really well on this one. There's 5 and 5. And then this is the final of 6 and 6. So that's how I keep count easily. So what we're going to do then for the next one, this is round number 3. This is the final. We're gonna start off with the chaining of 1 first. And we're going to start off with single crochet into the next one, and then the next one is going to be an increase, and we have to do that 6 times. So what I go is 1 and 1. So then the next one is by itself, and then this one will be 2 and 2, 2 single crochets. The next one's by itself, and then I go 3 and 3. It's just the way I count it. Next one's by itself, and it's 4 and 4. Next one's by itself, and then we have 5 and 5, and the next one's by itself, and then we have 6 and 6. And that took us all the way back around, and when we look at it, that's exactly what we needed to do. And then all you just do is just in the next stitch, just pull through and through for the slip stitch, leave on an extra long tail, and then that's the end sections of your bone, and then sew them onto your project accordingly.